Hello, my lovelies, and welcome to my channel. My name is Moon, and today I have a very exciting surprise unboxing for you. This unboxing is a surprise for me too. I thought I was done buying handbags for the year, and I made that decision this summer after buying a Dooney & Burke bag that I love very much. But then I had this thought that maybe I need to add one more bag that I could use for work from Louis Vuitton. And I decided to go ahead and splurge on that this week because I got a bonus check that I wasn't expecting. And so I was able to take that and put it towards this exciting, exciting purchase. And I'm so happy to add this bag to my collection. So without further ado, there it is. Ah! I just picked it up today. Curbside from Louis Vuitton. This is a bag that I was hounding online for weeks and I couldn't get it. And I called Louis Vuitton, I chatted with an advisor, I looked in the pre-loved market. I still couldn't find a bag that I wanted in this style. And then I decided I was gonna get it new. And I ended up calling my local Louis Vuitton store and voila, they were able to fix me up with this item. So without further ado, let me take the box out. I have opened it, but I have not, you know, really put anything inside the bag or really used it yet. Can you guess what it is? I'm gonna place it here on the table beside me. Here is the dust bag. And the bag in question is the Louis Vuitton Never Full GM in the Damier Azur print. Oh my goodness, you can see it's like folded down there because it's been sitting like this. So that crease will have to come out. But I absolutely love this bag. And what's exciting about it is that I have never owned such a huge bag from Louis Vuitton. All my bags have been, you know, Speedy 25, the Alma BB, the Pochette Accessoire. I haven't splurged on anything really big, but I did want to get myself a bag, like I said, that I could use for work. And I wanted to get it in a print that was not the monogram print so that it's more subtle. And what I love about this bag is that I feel it's going to patina over time and it's going to get this really casual, maybe slightly boho look. And I know people say that the Damier Azur is best for the summer, but I poo-poo that. I think you can wear it year-round, especially in Los Angeles, right? You can definitely get away with wearing this during the year, and as it patinas, I think that'll make it easier. It smells kind of perfumey. The SA I worked with gave me some free perfume samples, which were in the bag, so I think I can almost smell that perfume, or maybe even her perfume, since she was packing the bag. And she was kind enough, because we chatted over the phone, to send me a video of this bag and some, you know, virtual images. And I was like, I want this one. I was thinking about the rose ballerine interior, which is also beautiful, but I do like the simplicity of the beige white interior. And here is the pochette that comes along with the Never Full, which I've never owned since I do own a PM Never Full, but I purchased that pre-loved without the pochette. So this is my first time buying it new. Also my first Damier Azur piece. So I'm excited to maybe add a couple of other SLGs in this print. And I just really love, I love this checkerboard print. I like the creamy and, you know, dark blue gray color of it. I love that this is gonna patina. And right now I feel like I just wanna use this bag. You know, I wanna use it, I wanna take it to work. I'm a teacher, I need to carry a lot. And I also love that you can cinch the bag in on the side, which is the main reason why I didn't wanna get the MM, because you can cinch that in. I mean, I've seen that around town, I've seen that in videos, and it looks nice, but I just feel like there's something really cool about cinching the bag in this size. I just like the look of it. So I'm just gonna show you that. I still have to experiment a bit with the bag, but I am so freaking excited right now that this piece is in my hands. It was kind of a circus getting to the shop today. On the way back, I lost my cell phone and found it under the passenger seat. I was like so excited. I just wanted to get home and, you know, unpack my bag and style it and put different things in it and start using it, because I just feel like this is a bag that's gonna get a lot of use. And so I will, you know, spend a little time getting to know this bag, and then in the coming weeks I will post a more detailed review. I just wanted to do the unboxing today and share that with you. But you know, one thing I am in the market for now, having just purchased this, is a bag organizer. So if you have any bag organizers that you could suggest to me for the GM Neverfull, I would really, really appreciate that. We're just comparing this now to my PM. Oh my gosh, look at this. I'll do a comparison video maybe down the line with these two bags, because I love this little guy too. And I am so excited because I really do need a big old bag where on those days I want to carry the sun and everything and the moon and the stars, I can do that. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed my unboxing today. If you did, please give me a like and subscribe. I would love to have you follow me. Have a great week and stay stylish.